Everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another integral problem today. This one is actually going to involve integration by parts as well as integration with U substitution and even a trigonometric integral. So a lot of things going on in this problem. It was actually submitted by one of our viewers on YouTube. So the problem is the integral of arctan x dx. So whenever I have trigonometric integrals like this, to me, arctan's pretty rare. This isn't something that's readily apparent. I don't look at this and say like, oh, obviously the integral is whatever. So in that case, with trigonometric integrals, oftentimes a good place to start is integration by parts. It works well with a lot of trigonometric integrals, and the parts that you dissolve this function into, the first one is arctan x, and the second one is dx. So let's go ahead and use integration by parts, and remember the integration by parts formula, u dv, this part of course representing our function over here, equals uv minus the integral of v du. So remember, when we're using integration by parts, we need to first assign u and dv to values in our problem. So one other thing that's important in this problem, we're going to assign u to arctan of x, which means that we're going to need to know the derivative of arctan of x, and that is a formula. Obviously, you can derive it with a proof, but it's pretty complicated and kind of beyond the level of Calc 1 and 2. So my recommendation would be to take sine, cosine, tangent, secant, arctan, each one of the trigonometric functions, and put in your calculator or put on a formula sheet the integral of each one and the derivative of each one, so that you have those to reference, because otherwise there's no apparent way to just figure out what the derivative of arctan of x is. So that's what I would recommend. And we're going to go ahead and write it here. The derivative of arctan of x is 1 over x squared plus 1. That is the derivative of arctan of x. It's pretty complicated to figure out just how to find this, so this is something to memorize, put in your calculator, or write down on a formula sheet before an exam. So given that, let's go ahead and use our integration by parts formula. So we're going to assign, because this part is representing our function, we're going to assign u and dv to to values in our problem. So u we're going to assign to arctan of x, and dv we're going to assign to dx, or 1 dx, which when we're taking, when we're trying to find the integrals of trigonometric functions and we're using integration by parts, we'll end up with this here, because it'll be, you know, it'll be just sine of x or secant of x or something like that. So that means that your dv is always just going to end up being dx. And an easier way to remember that is that this is dx times 1, obviously, is the same thing as dx. But having that 1 here cues you in to the fact that v is x. We take the integral of dv to get v. And of course, the integral of 1 is just x. So that's how we get v. Du, of course, is the derivative of arctan of x, which we're going to grab from our formula over here. It's 1 over x squared plus 1. So we assigned u and dv to values in our problem, and then we took the derivative of u to get du, and we took the integral of dv to get v. So now that we have all four of these components, we go ahead and plug them back in to the right-hand side of this equation here, starting, of course, with u. So u, in this case, right, is arctan of x. V is x, so we multiply by x. And then we have minus the integral of v, so x, times du, which in this case is 1x squared plus 1. And then we always have to just add dx here because dx goes with this integral notation. So it's just notation. You just tack it onto the end there. So let's go ahead and simplify this. I don't think that we will need any of this anymore. So we can go ahead and simplify. So simplifying this, we'll move the x in front. X arctan of x minus the integral, and it'll be x over x squared plus 1 dx. All right, so there's our problem after we've used integration by parts. Normally, the goal of integration by parts, as you know, is to get this part here, what's inside the new integral, to be more simple than what we started out with, because this function we can't just integrate, but what we want to do is get to a point where this is something that we can integrate. So that's why we used integration by parts. And by the way, if you're having trouble with integration by parts, specifically U substitution, anything, I have all those sections on my website, so you can go there. So since this is still not simple enough to just see easily as something that we can simply integrate, we need to perform some other kind of operation to make this simpler. And the thing that pops out as most obvious, first thing you should always look at, if you need to make the integral simpler, the first three options you should go for are U substitution, integration by parts, and integration by partial fractions. Integration by parts, we don't usually like to use with fractions because it's difficult. So I wouldn't use integration by parts to simplify this again. I won't use integration by partial fractions because you can't factor the denominator here, and that's the dead giveaway for integration by partial fractions. So what I'm left with is U substitution, which does seem like a good candidate because if I assign U to x squared plus 1, then you'll end up with something like x over u, and that might end up being simple. So that's my first guess, and what we'll do is go ahead and try it. So we're gonna leave this alone for now and just focus on evaluating this integral with u substitution. And what we'll do is assign u to the most complicated part, which is x squared plus 1. So we'll say u equals x squared plus 1, and then as always with u substitution, we then take the derivative of u, which is du, and du is going to be 2x. And then when we do this, we always have to just tack on dx to the end of this. The reason being that we need to solve this equation here for dx. And we can't solve it for dx if we don't have dx in it. So we just tack on dx to the end and then solve for dx by dividing both sides by 2x. Which will leave us with dx equals du over 2x. So now that we've solved for dx, we can go ahead and plug back in to our function here. So we'll have x arctan of x, which we're just leaving alone, minus the integral x we left alone. Of course, we assign u to x squared plus 1 here, so this is u. And then we solve for dx here, and we said that it was du over 2x. So we plug du over 2x in for dx. So we get du over 2x. And looks like this is going to be great news. It's going to turn out well for us. I bet you're shocked. So what we need to do, you can see we have an x in the numerator and an x in the denominator, so those are both going to cancel. And we have a 2 in the denominator, or a coefficient of 1 half. Since everything inside the integral here is multiplied together, this is x over u times du over 2x, right? They're multiplied together. Since there's just one term inside the integral where everything is multiplied together, that means that there's a coefficient on this integral that can be moved outside of the integral like this. X arctan of x minus the 1 half, sorry, comes out in front. 1 half times the integral. We canceled the x's, so we're left with 1 over u du. So now that we've gotten to this point, the good news is that 1 over u du is finally something simple enough for us to integrate. So the integral, here's another rule for you. I know there's a lot of them in this problem. The integral of 1 over x equals natural log or ln of the absolute value of x plus c. This is something that you should absolutely have memorized, as opposed to just plugging it into your calculator or writing it down on a formula sheet, because it comes up so often that it's just important to kind of know it off the top of your head so you can be quick. Natural log of the absolute value of x. So let's go ahead and take the integral. We'll have x arctan of x minus 1 half, and then we just draw a big parenthesis because that symbolizes that, okay, here's the beginning of whatever is going to come out of this integral here. And the integral of this is, of course, natural log of the absolute value of u. And then we have to always add c to account for the constant. And then the only thing left to do, and I'm sorry that I erased it, I realized after the fact, but you remember that we had said that u was equal to x squared plus 1 before, when we had done the u substitution problem. All we need to do is plug back in x squared plus 1 for u, and simplify this, which there actually isn't a lot of simplifying to be done. So it's actually going to come out to be x arctan of x minus 1 half natural log or ln of the absolute value of x squared plus 1 plus c. And now that we've used integration by parts and u substitution back to back to integrate this arctan of x, we're done. And that's our final answer. Thanks, guys.